Well, I started when I was in high school and did like a teen talk show called Scratch. And then went to UCLA, and just from there, like, things just sort of escalated, and, you know. But I think it's so hard these days because I think there's a – you have to make the decision if you want to really be an actor or if you want to be famous, because there's a huge distinction between the two, and there's, like, reality television, and, you know, there's all these people who are, like, on shows where they did absolutely nothing, maybe make a sex tape, and then end up with this huge...
That could be exhausting.
Which can be exhausting, so I've heard. No, but, you know, they have a perfume line and a video game and a, you know what I'm saying? So it's, like, that's a completely different thing. Nobody, you don't have to be an actor to do that. And there's like 1,000 venues and, you know, singing competitions and, you know, bug eating competitions and, you know, all those sorts of things. So, you know, the people who want to be famous have that avenue. And then there are people who actually want to be actors. And if you want to be an actor, it takes a lot of work and training and craft and skill. And, you know, I was the gal who had like 1,000 jobs as like a personal assistant, and then I like if I would do that for a couple hours a day, and then I would go over here and like work at the bar, and then I would go over here and like deliver food for the zone, and you know what I mean. I had like the girl with 1,000 different jobs because I could, so I didn't have to be in an office to keep me. My parents kept saying like, you need to get a teaching degree so you have something to fall back on. I'm like, I just need to keep falling forward. I'm in my 20s. Like right now is the time to like be in acting class and make myself available. Like the people I know who didn't ever make it, like got something comfortable and then they couldn't leave to go do auditions and they didn't do anything to, so then they're now in their, you know, 40s and they're still going, well, maybe. And it's like, no. Like you have to do it when you're young in that way to like have that opportunity, and you're brave and you're stupid and you're, you know, doing theater and, you know, going to, you know, a million callbacks for commercials, and you're making money in like 1,000 different little jobs, so you can finally quit those to get, you know, when you, you know, have that opportunity to like do a real gig, you know. So I think you have to, there's a distinction to make that difference of like what is it you really, really want? Like, are you the person who's like, no, I'd rather be stuck in a dark room, like rehearsing with people, like for a while, you know, like that gives you that, you know, you're excited, you love it, you know, and you're willing to sacrifice, you know, a lot. Because it's not just the rejection of not getting the job. I mean, I am constantly not getting jobs. Like, you know, because nobody can have every really job. But that, it's not that. It's these other sacrifices that you're making. You know, being away from your children and traveling to, you know, do the jobs that are here, there, and everywhere, and all those sorts of things that, like, you know.
And the system here works differently because we have we've got more set up drama schools here.
You do. So you get like, better training.
We get more concise 3-year training, but it's I mean, I went to the Bristol Old Vic for 3 years. Loved it, did a lot of theatre, straight into TV. I was very lucky, touched that wood. But to start it now, I mean, I still believe in training. So, you know, back in Ireland, we have a fantastic place called The Lear, and that's got it's attached to Trinity College, and it's got an incredible training programme there. Because it just, it builds up your confidence, it gives you a sense of how to do it, how to exist within technique, and structure, and then creativity, and marrying them all together so that you don't fall off the stage.
Well, but and besides that, you have to be good. You know, it's not the once you've got the skills, then it's all this other stuff that you have to deal with.
Sure. You know, once you're out in the world, like, yeah, you build up your own learning curve there. But totally. You learn on the job, and
you do
off the
learn
job.
On the job, and you know, and then there's also learning the whole business aspect of like,
yeah.
You know, I mean, because there's not a room that I go to with all the other gals who are, like, now it's that same group of women, and we've all been doing it for a long time, and it's not like anybody's better, or you know, we've all done job, we're great.
Working actresses.
We're working actresses.
Thank you.
And it's just, I know, seriously, but it's about, you know, who's right for that different job, you know, it's a matter, it's like, it's just a, like, now it's just sort of like a, all right, she's going to go do this one, and you're going to do
but,
this one.
But, I mean, Merrin and I would be auditioning for the same part.
All the time.
All the time. Because it's you know, there in the States, over here when you're auditioning, you might be auditioning 20 actresses for a part that you know. In the States, it's, you know, it's such a vast pool of human beings that, you know, it's more like, well, we'll find out. Someone will come in and we'll go, That's who we want. Whereas here, right, they might have a much better idea of where they want to go because it's not such an enormous pool.
Yeah. But and like in America, you want to be on that short list of like casting directors who like know that they can count on you. When you go in that room, they're like, she's going to be fantastic. And it may not be, you know, like they might
not be right, but you're not going to
let them down. So you have to have the skill and the training. Like that's the bottom line, is that you have to, you cannot, like, I can't tell you how many people that are like just there because they think they're cute. They were the cutest person in, like, Iowa. You know, there's... I was listening to, like, one of my radio stations at home, and they were talking about these guys who are huge on YouTube. Now, Like, I'm so old now that I'm like... That there's a whole culture of other things of these people with their phone just doing a whole, like, show.
But my son won't watch TV, but he will watch YouTube videos.
Right.
Wow.
Yeah, no, I was like, somebody else was, they're like, oh, she met her favorite YouTube stars. They have a book at the Barnes & Noble. I'm like, what?
I know, but my boy goes on and goes, but Mom, I have to watch this video because then I know how to unlock the key and then the Enderman dragon. And I'm like, oh, you've lost me already.
Jesus, well, yeah.
It's something to do with Minecraft or something.
I know, Minecraft.
And then, I kind of go, okay, it's 5 minutes out of his life and he's learning something, isn't he? Is he? Yeah.
Is he quarter?
Yeah, yes.
But he's not, but there are people who have shows. So that's what I'm saying. It's like you have to decide what you want to do because those people who have to try to actually make the leap into acting, really acting in a thing, aren't any good because they don't know what they're doing.
But now there's this new... God, we're talking a lot. But there's a new thing now where you have a Q rating, which is really quite fascinating.
That's not new.
It's not new, but it's now so much newer because there's so many ways to access that. Because so as an actor, you're worth... to the producer or the production is, well, what's their Q rating? How many followers have they got? How many blah, blah, blah.
Followers. It's the followers.
It's all of that, which is quite extraordinary, which is why sometimes a YouTuber will get an opportunity to play Dr. McSteamy in the latest drama because he brings 17 million seven-year-olds who aren't going to watch a TV show, but neither here nor there. And it doesn't really matter if he's rubbish. He's just shown up and he brings his people. So it is a funny old business.
And that dilutes everything.
Well, it dilutes a certain level of it, but there's still, like you say, we are at the golden age of TV, and there's still some of the most incredible drama and comedy being made.
And people who are doing, like, I mean, I was just reading for a show where it's Billy Bob Thornton, William Hurt, you know, people who are doing TV who would never do TV because they'll do these, like, short little,
movie stars,
you know, Amazon and Hulu and Netflix and all these different places where you can, you know, and what's so great is that there's a lot of tremendous opportunity, but there's also a lot of tremendous product that you want to be a part of. So, you know, but I think if you want to...
A lot of really excellent scripts coming out.
Yeah. But summing it up, if like you want to act, you got to actually know how to act. If you want to be famous, there's 1,000 other ways to do it.